Now, if the temperature increases, what will happen? All valence electrons occupy the valence energy band. Now, if the temperature increases, the valence electrons may gain thermal energy. If thermal energy is gained by, suppose say, this silicon atom, so that will break the silicon bond. Now, what is the band gap energy? The energy required to move from valence band to the conduction band. Now, when this electron moves away, or you can say the electron that gains this minimum energy now goes in the conduction band and moves towards the crystal. The net flow of electrons in the conduction band generates a current. That means this free electron now moves to the other part and this will generate the current in the crystal. Now you can see here, this is the conduction band, conduction energy level and valence energy level. Now what you can see from the diagram, the energy EV is nothing but the maximum energy of the valence band. This is your valence band and this is the maximum level of the valence band. So EV is nothing but the maximum energy of the valence energy band, and EC, what you can say, this is the conduction band. So this is the minimum energy level, so that you can call it as the minimum energy of the conduction energy band. Now what is this? The part between the conduction band and the valence band is called as the forbidden band gap. The band gap energy is the difference. You can say this is denoted by E suffix G. It is the difference between the conduction band and the valence band. Now electrons cannot exist between this part, that is the valence and conduction band, right? Now you can see from the diagram, if an electron gains energy, you can say, suppose an electron over here in the valence band gets an energy, it will move from valence band to the conduction band when this much band gap energy is provided to the electron which is at the valence band region. How you can define insulators then conductors from this? Insulators are materials, or you can say insulator materials are those which have band gap energies. This energy band gap for insulator is between 3 to 6 electron volts. So that means there is no electron in the conduction band, and hence there is no flow of current in such type of materials. Hence in insulators you have large band gap energy, so there is no flow of electrons in the insulators. In contrast, if you have a semiconductor, semiconductor have the same band gap energy as 1 electron volt. So very small energy is required for an valence band electron to move from valence band to conduction. So it is easier to move an electron from valence band to conduction band in a semiconductor, because the band gap energy is only 1 electron volt, whereas in the insulator you have it as 3 to 6 electron volts. This is how we define the band gap energy. Now coming to the last part, what you can see, if the temperature increases, large number of covalent bonds, if the temperature increases, more covalent bonds will break, so you'll have large number of free electrons. Suppose say this covalent bond is broken, so the electron from here will move over here, so here you have a positive charge. Since electron is coming here, you have negative charge, here you have positive charge. Again, if an electron which was there in this position over here has already moved to other part, you can say here again a hole is created. This is how the current flows in the crystal structure in an intrinsic semiconductor. Again repeating, suppose you have a bond structure, and if the temperature increases, or you can say if you are providing electric field, so large number of free electron hole pair are created. So if electron moves from this part to this part, a vacancy is created, which is nothing but a hole. Suppose this electron moves over here, a negative charge is created. Similarly, if an electron from this point has already moved to other part, so again a hole is created. This is how the electrons flow, which will generate the electric current in an intrinsic semiconductor.